Hi everybody and welcome to another Logic Pro X video. Today let's take a look at the update 10.5 for Logic Pro X. Let's take a look at the quick sampler and sampler and see if we can create a granular instrument. My name is Matthias and this is Morning Dew Media. Let's take the tour. Okay, so here we are in Logic Pro X 10.5, and as you can see, there's quite a big change here. You now have this clip launching view, which you can deactivate and activate. The same thing goes for your arrangement view here, which you also can deactivate and activate if you want. So the first thing which happens when you boot up Logic 10.5 is that it asks if you want to keep the old key commands or use the new key commands. Apparently, there's so many new features that they had to change a lot of the key commands or add key commands. But basically, most of the old features are still the same key commands. So Command K to bring up the musical typing, for example. But that's something I just wanted to mention here, that there have been some changes to the key commands. Okay, so this is the clip launching view, and I did a live stream quite recently about this new update. We looked at the clip launching, some of the sampling features, and we also made a short, quick song arrangement, which we then transferred to the arrangement view here. But we can quickly just play the clips here. Yeah, so that's a short music snippet that we created in the live stream. So if you want to check out that live stream, you can click on the link in the description to this video, or maybe up here in the corner. Anyway, so let's check out the sampler and quick sampler and see how they differ and if we can create a granular instrument with the quick sampler. So we have two new samplers in Logic 10.5, and one of them is the quick sampler. And it looks like this. So the new sampler of Logic 10.5 has a very sleek design. It follows the same design principles that Logic started with, I think it was the Logic 10 update. But anyways, they've of course made it vectorized, so you can zoom in and out if you have a big monitor without any loss of quality. So that's a nice feature when you have a vectorized interface. And yeah, so the quick sampler is for using single samples. And with these single samples, you can either have them at classic mode, which just plays the sample from the beginning to the end, or from the beginning to the looping point. So you can't have multi-samples within the quick sampler. It's for the sampler. And you also can play them in one-shot mode, which basically just don't give you that looping feature. And you can play them at slicing mode. And it has a very nice, quick analyzing method for finding the transients within your drum loops, etc. We can just check that out quickly here. Just create a new instrument track, new software instrument track. By default, I've set it to the sampler. The sampler, of course, has more settings, so you have all these pages. But as I mentioned, you can check out that live stream replay video if you want to learn more about how the actual sampler works. Let's go back here and create the quick sampler instead. A stereo single sample sampler. And let's find a drum loop. So dragged it in here. And we can select either as the original, just keep the original tuning. Or we can use the optimized setting here for optimized tuning, loudness, and search for loop points, etc. And crop the silence, which is a nice feature. So let's drag that here, and we can see that it's set it to classic mode. But for a drum sample like this, we want to have it in slice mode. So now it automatically detects all the transients within this sample. And as I'm using a Wacom for my editing here, I can actually use the pinching here to zoom in and zoom out of the sample to make more precise editing. if you want to be really, really, really surgical about your edits. And you also have the snapping here to zero crossing, which is very great. And the zero crossing is to find the points within the sample or within the waveform, which starts close to the zero crossing, which means that it has a zero volume. If you have a sample starting at your waveform when it's in the top or the low region, you will hear a click at the start of your sample. So that's that can be nice to set it to zero crossing if you want to have nice and smooth beginnings to your samples. So now we have this one chopped up to slices. One thing to mention here is that these slices are just reference points to your sample. So Logic only maps the reference points to your original sample. So we can't go in here and reverse certain parts of the sample. And that can be annoying because it would have been really great to have this one. Chop up the sample and then we could reverse certain parts here, like you can do in some of the other samplers. With that said, it's definitely in the right direction, but hopefully in an update we can see some chopping to slice or onsets, and then we can reverse some of these samples. That would have been really nice. Then of course you have the recorder mode, which is for recording or sampling new samples into this sampler. Okay, so let's begin and create our granular instrument. So we have this new sampler, we set it to classic mode, and we will find our own sample. So we can drag this sample and choose optimized. So this is a harmonette sample, so it sounds like an accordion. Okay, so to make this granular, we need to find a way to set a really short loop point, because granular synthesis is all about playing small portions of your sample and maybe move the playhead through the sample and find different parts and characteristics within the sample. So how to do that? Well, we have the loop points here. This is the beginning loop point, the loop start point, and the loop ending point. If you want to learn more about granular synthesis, I highly suggest that you check out my previous video on granular synthesis and my top 5 plugins for creating granular synthesis. There we speak more thoroughly about how to work with granular synthesis and what it is, etc. Okay, so let's get back here. So we need a way to shorten this looping point, because as of now it's playing a quite long loop. So yeah, just drag this ending point back here and we have a short loop. Then we can maybe drag this back even further, the starting point and the ending point, so they are very close together. And we also need to move the starting point of the sample, which is the starting point when you press down a key. It will start from the loop start here and go into our loop section. So we move this starting point a little bit further here down the sample. So now it sounds static and boring, and we need a way to get rid of this boringness in the sample. Now we can use the LFO here in combination with the modulation matrix and assign this low frequency oscillator to the play or the loop starting position. So let's make this one a random LFO. And we can just drag down the hertz value so it's not oscillating so fast. Just drag that down slightly. And go to the mode matrix and set our LFO 1 to destination loop starting point. And now if I press down a key here on the keyboard, and we introduce a little bit of modulation depth here, you can hear it still sounds static, but that's because every time I hit the key, we get the same oscillation, or the random LFO is restarting. So we need to depress the key triggering here. So we set LFO 1 to sample start position, and we set LFO 1 also to the loop starting position. And we can set starting position somewhere here and a very short loop region. Then we also look at the quantization modulation. So we set the loop starting and end, maybe to 132. And the same thing for the sample start. And if we want a slower change, we can of course just decrease the rate here for the LFO. Let's go ahead here and add LFO 2 to our looping position. And make sure the same thing here, we need to depress the key trigger here. And also make this one a random smooth LFO. And we can also drag down the rate slightly here. And see how this affects our sound. You can also make this unipolar, so it only goes from your initial position and onwards into the sample. If you have this set to bipolar, it will also go backwards and forwards from your original position. But I highly suggest that you make this one unipolar. And the same thing with your first LFO. So now we can make this to a really lush pad just by adding a little bit of effects here. So we can add first the tape delay and do some changes here because we want to have a quite mellow delay for this one. So add a little bit of flutter intensity, a little bit of flutter rate, so we have a little bit of movement in the delays here. And also some chroma verb, so we get more lush sound. Introduce the decay slightly here. Maybe reduce the wetness here. Drag a little bit of the bass. And also we can do a little bit of high cut here, below 200. And if we want a more mellow sound, as I mentioned, we can just decrease the LFO rates here. So you can experiment here with more narrow changes in the modulation. Maybe decrease the length of this loop region. And we can of course work with the filter here if we want a more mellow and smooth sound. Yeah, so that was a quick example how you can use the Quick Sampler to create a granular instrument very quickly here in Logic Pro X 10.5. Please let me know in the comment section below what's your favorite features of Logic 10.5. My name is Matthias, now you can continue and watch my next episode. Have a real nice weekend and see you in the next video. Bye!